Hello everyone, so already I have explained the direct iteration method. So now it's backed iteration. So addition of known excess amount of standard EDTA to the sample. In case of backed iteration, we have to add standard EDTA, excess standard EDTA to the sample. The medium is buffered, so buffer medium we are taking, and excess EDTA is titrated with standard solution of another metal ion. This may be magnesium or zinc. So it is used in the following cases. So insoluble substance, if it is present, insoluble substance. So like you can see BaSO4, PbSO4, these are the insoluble substances. Usually soluble in hot EDTA. And the reaction between metal and EDTA is low, incomplete, you can say incomplete. Like you can see the example, like Al, Cr, these are these metals which show a slow reaction or incomplete reaction with EDTA. And the metal is precipitate at the pH of suitable for the titration, that is aluminium hydroxide, and the color change at the end point, that is the from free indicator color to a metal indicator complex. So in case of direct titration, it is opposite. And in this back titration, here you can see the determination of aluminium salt. So sample of aluminium is heated with a known excess amount of standard EDTA at pH of 7 to 8, and the solution is then adjusted to pH 10 using ammonia buffer. And a residual EDTA is titrated against the standard zinc using EBT, that is aeochrome black tea indicator. And the color changes from blue to wine red. Here you can see the reaction I have given, what will happen in the pH 7 to 8. After that we have to adjust the pH 10, and at last we are getting a wine red, from blue to wine red. Then the third one is replacement titration. When both back titration and direct titration is not possible due to the endpoint not being served enough, so then the replacement titration is method of choice. In this method of titration, determination of metal ion is done by the displacing the magnesium or zinc ion from EDTA. So complex with an equivalent amount of metal ion and liberated magnesium or zinc ions are then titrated with the standard EDTA solution. So modern black is used as an indicator. And the calcium salt is determined in the way we have to add standard volume of magnesium EDTA solution to a calcium salt in the presence of buffer. Then calcium displaces magnesium ion and form a stable complex with EDTA as a calcium EDTA complex. Then displaced and liberated magnesium ions are then titrated and standard EDTA solution using modern black as an indicator. So here you can see the determination of calcium salt. And like cadmium, lead and mercury can also be determined by this titration. And the last one is alkalimetric titration of metals. So metal EDTA complex formation reaction explains that the proton are liberated from disodium EDTA irritate, leading to formation of acid. So the acid that is formed can be titrated against the standard alkali, but in an unbuffered solution, the endpoint detection can be done by using acid base or visual indicator or potentiometric method of detecting the endpoint. After that, we have masking agent and demasking agent. So masking agents are the reagents which prevent the interfering ion from reaction without physical separation. Here you can see some example of masking agent and masking agents. I have given the example, the KCN, triethanomaline, fluorite and iodide. And for demasking agent is the process in which masking substances reverse back to its ability to take part in the reaction. Another reagent which regain the ability of masked ion we enter the reaction with indicator and EDTA. Example I have given here, you can see with the reaction. Thank you.